All right, guys, please be seated. And now I will request everybody to take your seats so that we can officially begin our today's ceremony. So we are actually waiting for our Fesla Path batch, but we'll start in the interest of time. So as they join in, I would request all of you to please give them a warm welcome because they are traveling and they are coming here for their graduation ceremony. Thank you.
All right. So in the next 10 seconds, we will be starting off with the graduation ceremony officially. Please make sure that you are seated. People standing on the first floor, on ground floor, please get yourself seated. We will start off with the graduation ceremony now. तो ग्रेजुएशन सेरेमनी स्टार्ट कर ले. आवाज नहीं आ रही इधर वाले हमारे फेलोज, ग्रेजुएशन सेरेमनी स्टार्ट कर ले. वकास, आवाज आ रही है?
आई वांट अगेन टू लिसन फ्रॉम दिस. आप लोगों की इजाजत है हम शुरू कर लें? अगर आप लोग इजाजत नहीं देंगे नहीं शुरू करते, ठीक है? सो ऑल राइट चले आ जाओ.
People at the back, please find yourself a seat. We're starting off with the graduation ceremony now. People near the entrance gates, please find yourself a seat right away. Walt Disney says, and I quote, "All of our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them." Today, as I stand on this stage, welcoming thousands of young minds who represent the youth of Pakistan, I can undoubtedly witness the courage, the commitment, and the grit that is needed to convert our dreams into reality. A big round of applause for all of you.
Assalamu alaikum, good morning, and very warm welcome to our chief guest, Dr. Faisal Bari, Mr. Mohammad Khosa, and Hatim Khan. And of course, I'm not forgetting the people for whom this day is staged, our amazing fellows who are joining in person, as well as who are watching this graduation ceremony through live stream. I am Vakas Heather, currently working as program manager at Amal Academy.
And I am Hajra Mirza, working as a program associate at Amal Academy. Vakas, आपको पता है आज ये graduation ceremony इतनी special क्यों है?
I don't know. आप मुझे बता सकती हैं?
So this graduation ceremony is certainly one of its kind, because we don't just have our audience in Lahore, but we have our audience joining us in Karachi and in Peshawar online. So guys, a big round of applause for our audience in Karachi, Peshawar, and all the way in Lahore. So in Karachi, we have Ms. Quratul Ain with us, who's leading the audience. So Ms. Quratul Ain, can you hear us? All right, let's move on to our audience in Peshawar. Ms. Amna Javed, can you hear us? Theek ho gaya, sahi hai. So we have our audience in three different cities, and today it's all on you. And you have to prove which city has the most energy, right?
Hajra, do you know how many fellows are graduating today?
I think we have fellows from the winter 2020 semester, spring 2021, and summer 2021.
Wow. Seriously, that makes 2,300 fellows who are graduating today. बट नो नॉइस आई कांट हियर एनीबॉडी, किसी की भी आवाज नहीं आ रही है. आई कैन सी नो एक्सप्रेशन, आई कैन सी दैट दे आर सिटिंग विद अ ब्लैंक फेसेस. सो गाइस कैन वी हियर सम नॉइस फ्रॉम यू ऑल? नो नो अभी भी नहीं, अभी भी नहीं. गाइस कैन वी हियर सम नॉइस फ्रॉम यू ऑल?
नॉइस से याद आया, व्हाई नॉट यूटिलाइज द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ प्रोग्रेस दैट हैज बीन टॉट टू आवर फेलोज ड्यूरिंग द फेलोशिप प्रोग्राम. आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट एक और एक ग्यारह.
ओ दैट्स अ ब्रिलियंट आइडिया. सो व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल से एक और एक एंड द ऑडियंस विल हैव टू से. What audience will say? Yes. So, ek aur ek. I want more noise. Ek aur ek. Nahi, 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 nahi. Maza nahi aa raha. So, Hajra, how about we have a competition between the cities, right? Thoda sa competition kara le. Lahore. Kara le competition.
That's a great idea. So, I hope our audience is ready in Karachi, Peshawar and in Lahore. Let's hear some noise from Karachi. Ek aur ek.
Yeah.
Karachi wale fellows ki baat ho rahi hai. So Karachi audience, ek aur ek.
Yeah.
Let's move on to the next city.
So let's hear from Peshawar. Peshawar, ek aur ek. So no, we can't hear from Peshawar. Amna, can we hear from you all? Ek aur ek.
Chalein ji, Karachi aur Peshawar ne to bata diya ki energy kam hai. So Lahore wale hamare fellows, it's time to prove. Ek aur ek. Ek aur ek. Ek aur ek. Wonderful, brilliant. Now that is the kind of energy we expect from our audience in all three cities. Please remain as energetic and enthusiastic as possible, as we will now officially start off with the ceremony. Before we do so, it is important to talk about some rules and regulations of this event. Please ensure that your phones are on silent mode. Please be respectful and attentive when our guests are on the stage addressing you. And last but not the least, don't forget that this is the best opportunity to show and prove to our guests how Amal Fellows are different. Without further delay, let's officially begin the event. I would request Nagin Kayum from batch 179 to please come on stage and recite a few verses from the Holy Quran.
Assalamu alaikum everyone. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Amana ar-rasulu bima لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله وقالوا سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت ربنا لا تؤاخذنا نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا كما حملته كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا لا تؤاخذنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا واغفر لنا فارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا للقوم الكافرين آمنت بالله صدق الله العظيم.
Jazakallah khair. So before we move forward, let's check the technology, right? So Peshawar, can you please check that? Can you please just speak so that we can hear you? Amna.
Yes. Can am I audible?
Yes, we can hear you now.
Perfect.
Quratul Ain, can you please speak now? All right, so Ma'am Kurat, can you please hear us?
Hello, can you guys hear us?
Yes, now we can hear you, but I think the voice is not that much clear, so please just speak once more.
Let me try again. Vakas, can you guys hear us now?
Yes, we can hear you now. So before, again, our fellows from Faisalabad have joined and they are just at the registration desk. So within a minute, when they just come to this hall, I would just pause for a minute and I would just request you all to please welcome jo hamare mehmanane grami aa rahe hain. Of course they are our guests, kyunki wo Faisalabad se Lahore aa rahe hain and Lahore wale waise apni mehman nawazi ke liye jaane jaate hain, right? So jaise hi wo andar aaye, please keep clapping for them as they have been traveling for past three hours, right? So it's very, very important to give them a very warm welcome. After Tilawat, in today's agenda, we will be hearing the amazing stories of our fellows, the inspirational words from our chief guest, and at the end, we have few performances. Hajra, I remember you have been a fellow too, right?
Yes, Vakas, I have been a fellow in this incredible fellowship program, and I can see my fellows sitting right over there. Trust me, this has been one of the most transformational rides of my life. This fellowship pushed me out of my comfort zone. It made me believe in myself, and it made me realize my true potential. Yes, it required dedicated time and effort, but today, my fellows and I have transformed into persistent and resilient individuals.
So today is the day which our fellows have been excitedly waiting for. This is the reward of all the efforts and all the time when you all went extra mile to just work on your project works for your own learning, to just prepare your resumes and prepare for the mock interviews. So without any further delay, I would like to hear an amazing story from our fellow from Karachi. She will be our first valedictorian of the day, and her name is Sana Iftikhar. She is from batch 175. And with this, I am giving you your first valedictorian, Sana Iftikhar.
Assalamu alaikum, everyone. I'm Sana Iftikhar, an electronics engineer from NID University and a very jolly Amal fellow from batch 175. I've always found it easy to set goals and make plans for myself. but Amal actually taught me how to achieve them. The main reason why I joined Amal was because I wanted to bring a change in my life, no matter how big or small. Amal promises young students and graduates the freedom to grow and explore their choices. And this is exactly what I wanted to do in 2020 when I joined Amal. When I got the favorite interview call, I was determined to show the interviewer my eagerness to join the program. And luckily I got selected in. I was first put in Sarah Anise's and Madam Ikra's batch. I spent the first few weeks of my fellowship quietly observing my fellows. They were highly opinionated and very intelligent. I wouldn't be lying if I said I got a little bit intimidated by them. But as the weeks went on, I found myself participating in the sessions more actively. The sessions conducted by our facilitation team were brilliantly curated and allowed for everyone in the batch to share their thoughts. Aside from that, the project work at Amal also helped us to express ourselves openly, something which I had not been doing in my university life. University life can be very good for your academic career, but it can actually restrict your social, creative, and cognitive growth. On the other hand, our facilitation team let us be creative with our assignments as they made us think up of exciting new solutions and were genuinely enthusiastic for us to become the best versions of ourselves. Somewhere along the way, I began to wake up excited for my 10 a.m. sessions. I was super enthusiastic to learn more about entrepreneurship and how business models is actually implemented. The AMU courses were also a big part of the AMU program. I still find myself revisiting the passenger and superhero cover. Okay. I still find myself, the AMU courses were also a major part of the AMU program. I still find myself revisiting the superhero resume and super partner cover letter series, even months after I've graduated from AMU. My AMUL journey was beautifully positive and something I won't be able to forget anytime soon. It made me grow into a much more confident, talkative, and positive person. And I think I speak for everyone out here when I say that AMUL brought a sense of tranquility in our chaotic lives. So thank you so much to my facilitation team and to all of the facilitation teams here and to AMUL for supporting me and many young kids like me to discover their way in this world. Thank you so much.
Bye. That was absolutely beautiful, Sana. The way Sana said, I got selected. I think that satisfaction, that peace that our alumni have when they talk about the rewarding journey after the fellowship is what really matters. Our second valedictorian has joined us from Peshawar, and I cannot wait to hear her reflections. Please give a big round of applause to Nabiha Gul from batch 207. Nabiha Gul.
Assalamu alaikum and greetings to everyone. I hope you're all doing fantastic and are feeling quite thrilled and excited to be a part of this graduation ceremony. So to begin with, I'd first like to thank Amal Academy for giving me this amazing opportunity to represent my fellow graduates. And it is such an amazing honor and words fail to express how delighted I feel right now. Now to my friends and fellow graduates, congratulations on making it this far. And I think we all deserve a pat on the back for all those hours we spent completing online courses, all those all-nighters we pulled completing our mega projects. And let's not forget that we chose to spend these 3 months, including our weekends, on this long but worthwhile journey. Now, obviously, all of it wasn't for nothing, because when we all chose to apply for this fellowship, we all made this conscious decision that we're going to spend these 3 months into our self-improvement. And for most of us, this grueling but worthwhile journey has proven to be much more than that. The fact that you're all here sitting in this graduation ceremony and the fact that I can address all of you is a part of that transformation. And now, among all the long list of amazing, valuable, life-changing lessons that we've learned at Amal Academy, my favorite has got to be having a growth mindset. That is approaching every situation, every adversity as a growth opportunity. And I think because even though our Amal journey is coming to an end, our journey of self-improvement is never truly over. And it is rooted in being a lifelong learner. And as we will all continue down to our own lives, we will face many challenges and difficulties. And it is this mindset, it is this potential that we can choose to look at those situations as adversities or as opportunities to grow, that's going to make all the difference in our lives. Now, that aside, let's talk a bit about our mega projects. And no, I'm not going to talk about the grueling and the tedious details because we're all too familiar with those. What I'm going to talk about is that how working on those projects made us realize this amazing potential that each and every one of us has within us. It is this potential to do good, to give back to our community and to make a positive impact, no matter the scale and with the resources that we all already possess. It is this ability, it is this potential that Amal made us realize while working on those project works. And the fact that, and it made us realize this fact that it's all within our grasp and all that's required for us is to take the first step, is to take the action. Now, throughout the fellowship, Amal kept pushing us out of our comfort zone. And even though it was painful at times, I think we're all grateful that we went through that hardship, because the reward feels so much sweeter when you've worked hard for it. And I'd say that success is counted sweetest when you've persevered through hardships and you work hard to achieve that success. Lastly, a huge thanks to Amal and PepsiCo for giving us this amazing opportunity to grow, and to our facilitators for being so kind and being the best teachers out there, and to everyone who is involved in making this whole journey memorable one. Thank you, everyone, and congratulations.
Thank you, Nabiha, for such an amazing reflection of your own journey. So we will take a pause of just 1 minute, and we'll warmly welcome our fellows from Faisalabad. So I will request all the fellows in Rahore to please clap for Faisalabad. Keep clapping so that they know that they are being welcomed. While the fellows from Faisalabad are settling down, I would like to just remind one thing and the one value that as Amal Fellow we all embody is of respect. So wherever someone is speaking, we need to show respect by listening very carefully to what the person has to say. And I remember that how much you guys respected your program managers, program associates, and your fellows. So think of this place as a session on the weekend that you are taking. And all of the people that are sitting here are like your fellows, right? So I would request you all to just show some respect. So if somebody is speaking, whether that person is from Peshawar or from Karachi or from Lahore, we need to give that person a due respect. So I hope that I don't need to repeat this instruction once again.
Acha ji, so we have our audience joining us from Faisalabad, and I'm sure our audience in Lahore, Karachi, and Peshawar already know about the energizer we have been having in our ceremony so far. So time to practice the power clap once again. Taki Faisalabad walon ko bhi pata chale ye power clap hai kya. So again, Vakas, over to you.
All right, so once again, 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, All right, so once again, 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 5. No, I had आपने वन पे क्लैप करना है सबने. सो वंस अगेन 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1. Once again, I am seeing this side is very energetic and this side is not energetic at all. So can I have you guys to please just stand up and then clap, right? So are you guys ready? All right. So 3, 2, 1. Nobody stood up, right? I said stand up and then clap. So 3, 2, 1. You guys are not listening to the instructions, right? So please listen carefully. Stand up and then clap. 3, 2, 1. Yes, I see few fellows just rising up from their seat and then clap. Instructions are a bit changed, right? Stand up and then clap. Sit down for some time. Sit down. All right. So 3, 2, 1. Yes, more fellows, right? All of you have to stand up and then clap. 3, 2, 1. अब ये वाली साइड थोड़ी सो गई है, एक दफा दोबारा से 3, 2, 1. You need to stand up actually and then clap. Once again, 3, 2, 1. Why there is so much segregation? ये वाले क्लैप करते हैं, खड़े नहीं होते. ये वाले खड़े हो जाते हैं, क्लैप नहीं करते. So we need both of these things. So once again, 3. And again from Peshawar and Karachi as well, you guys need to stand up and then clap. So 3.
Guys, stand up. Yes, stand up.
Yes, Amna, they need to stand up. Thank you. So 3, 2, 1. Yes, there is a bit lag in the technology. So we'll just do it for one last time. So it should be a power clap so that we feel the energy. 3, 2, 0. 3, 2, 1. So as Nabiya was saying that one of Amal's goal, Amal's journey teaches is you to be the lifelong learners. And I hope that as you are joining today and as you are graduating today, your learning should not stop. You should not stop learning. You must explore and start exploring about yourself. Thank you so much for saying that, Nabiha. And from Lahore, we are joined by Arslan Farooq. He is from Batch 205 and he is the valedictorian from Lahore, Arslan Farooq.
Assalamu alaikum, ladies and gentlemen. I welcome you all here. Dear Amal fellows, guess what? We are finally graduating. I feel honored to deliver a speech at our graduation ceremony. That sentiments that I feel and I am sure everyone else can also resonate with. First of all, congratulations to all of you. Today, you all have successfully graduated from Amal Academy. A big round of applause for all of you. As you are graduating today, your families are extremely proud of you. You cannot imagine the sense of relief they are experiencing. And I think this would be a most opportune time to ask for money. As I stand here before you, I would like to share my journey and experience with you. I assure you, you will love to hear and feel my words. My time at Amal filled my heart and soul with all the lessons I could imagine to attain for the rest of my life. But that doesn't mean those lessons were all and I'm done with the learning. Amal has taught me it doesn't matter which stage you are in. You still have to be a learner, a lifelong learner. As a student, we are able to excel in our technical skills that we learn from our degree, but we are missed on the soft skills. And the fact is, the student from all the disciplines, whether it's a business student or a science student, everyone needs the soft skills along the side of technical know-how. This is where Amal comes in. This is why I have aligned myself with Amal Academy. I found the Amal Academy through an advertisement and started exploring more about the fellowship program. Before Amal journey, I did have the leadership experience, but I didn't know the full potential of them nor my soft skills. I joined this fellowship because I wanted to be a confident person so that whenever I can see myself in a mirror, I can feel proud of my work and my accomplishment so that I can see I have really scored something in my practical life. So I want to know, attention please, I want to know how many of you actually miss the weekend sessions? Oh, I can see some hand raising. My morning on Saturday and Sunday morning don't feel the same at all. I was highly excited about the amazing activities took place in the sessions, and my mates in the session would always appreciated me, which boosted my self-confidence. I would also like to mention about my program manager and program associate as well, who always spoke highly of me. Without the facilitation team, I would not be able to stand here and deliver this speech to you. Now, that's we all are here. It's time to implement the Amal rules in our life. I have already started implementing them, such as speaking in the front of public, being a team player, and excelling as a leader. After adopting all these techniques, I would like to share my biggest achievement that I am most proud of. I got selected in the best project of my university and appointed as a team leader of the project named Hybrid Formula One. And also, I have successfully cleared the courses from American Petroleum Institute, API 610. The best thing about my Amal journey was the bond that was created with my fellows. I made a lot of new friends, and I am sure you also have the supportive and motivating individuals who always help you to grow in your life. I will always remember this place and will always thankful to the Amal for giving me the nourished environment. My advice to you is, as you get ready to cross this stage last time, make sure you are around when your friend need to lean on you. Main apni is baat ka ihtitam ek sher se karna chahta hoon. Arz kiya hai. वक्त सबको मिलता है जिंदगी बदलने के लिए. वक्त सबको मिलता है जिंदगी बदलने के लिए, लेकिन जिंदगी दोबारा नहीं मिलती वक्त बदलने के लिए. थैंक यू अमल फॉर चेंजिंग माय लाइफ. आई विश यू ऑल द बेस्ट ऑफ लक फॉर द फ्यूचर, एंड इंशाल्लाह मे यू गाइस बी द राइज एंड द शाइन फॉर योर फैमिली and our country Pakistan after your hard work, passion and dedication. Thank you so much all for your time.
Bahut khoob Arsalan, and thank you so much for this powerful speech. So once again, I am just going to ask our audience in Karachi and Peshawar to let us know if you're all on the same page. Sab samaj aa rahi hai, sab energy sabki high hai, nahi hai. So Miss Amna, what do you think?
जी, आई थिंक पेशावर वाली साइड पे तो बड़ी अच्छी एनर्जी जा रही है. बिकॉज व्हाट हैपेंड गाइस, आप लोगों को कैसे बताते हैं कि एनर्जी अच्छी है. हमने क्या बताया था, कैसे हमने एक व्हाट्स दैट वन वर्ड जिसे आप वेलकम करते हो. एब्सोल्युटली. एंड अभी भी वैसे मजा नहीं आया, ये वाली साइड अभी भी ठंडी है. कैसे करते हैं? एब्सोल्युटली. सो आप पता चला आपको लाहौर और कराची के हमारी पेशावर वालों की एनर्जी कितनी अच्छी है.
डेफिनेटली पेशावर वाले तो बड़ा कंपटीशन दे रहे हैं. सो लेट्स सी व्हाट आवर ऑडियंस इन कराची फील्स लाइक. मिस कुरत, ओवर टू यू.
So I think people from Karachi here are absolutely thrilled and are watching with, you know, as much enthusiasm as possible. Karachi, can they hear you? So I think Hajra, were you able to hear that?
Yes. And I think it's time to prove to Peshawar and Karachi ki hamari jo energy hai wo sabse high hai. So Lahore audience, ek aur ek best. So I think the audience in Peshawar and Karachi would be slightly tense by now, because we have certainly given them a tough competition. Good job, guys. Please maintain the audience. We have our fellows from Faisalabad, Lahore, even fellows in the hall downstairs, and yet we still have people joining us. So keep the energy high, because we have a lot to share in the remaining portion of the ceremony. Once again, I'd like to congratulate all valedictorians for their achievement. You have certainly made us all very proud. The journey of creating an impact would certainly not have been possible alone, which is why the entire team at Amal Academy would like to thank our supporter, PepsiCo Pakistan. PepsiCo Pakistan has played an equal role in empowering our fellows to learn and give back to the society. Starting back in 2013, over 8,000 fellows from different parts of the country have successfully graduated from this fellowship program and are currently serving as lifelong learners. Today, our fellows are doing exceptionally well in their personal as well as professional lives. So let's ask Ms. Haya Fatima, Program Manager at Amal Academy, to please come on stage and enlighten us with the impact we have been able to create over the last 1 year. Ms. Haya Fatima, over to you. Just give us a second. We're getting the presentation ready and we'll start. Assalamu alaikum, fellows and our esteemed guests. It is my absolute pleasure to be talking about the incredible things we have achieved this year. A lot of questions were raised when the pandemic started about the learning loss in COVID. We are so proud of our fellows who took this opportunity to not only survive, but thrive through this time. Today, we will be celebrating our fellows, our team, and our biggest partners. So I want to hear all of you cheer as loud as you can, as we join together to celebrate your success. This year, over 2,200 fellows graduated the Amal Career Prep Fellowship, and 1,100 of them were women, exceeding well beyond our targets. So can I hear from the women, please? Amal also launched a teacher training program, and the pilot was partnered with the Punjab Higher Education Commission. And in the first program, we were able to graduate 30 university teachers. As part of the Amal Fellowship program, we ask our fellows to move out of their comfort zones and go outside to raise funds for a very well-renowned foundation, the Eidi Foundation. I know how much everyone loves doing this activity. The purpose of this activity is to develop grit and resilience within our fellows and to make them realize their ability to make a difference. It is with incredible pride and joy I announce that all of you fellows present in this room and all the fellows watching us in Karachi and Peshawar have collectively been able to raise 52 lakh rupees. This would not have been possible without the spectacular efforts all of you put in. So give yourself a round of applause. We cannot move forward without talking about the most exciting part of the fellowship, the AMIL Mega Projects. The Mega Projects are an opportunity for our fellows to practice everything that they learn in within the fellowship. They work in groups and their projects primarily focus on sustainable social impact and entrepreneurship. Over the past 1 year, our fellows have engaged in over 350 Mega Projects and have impacted 9,000 individuals. So these are the names of the best mega projects from each batch. Can I hear everyone cheer for their own batch, please? We will not get a chance to go over each every single project, but we have highlighted a few which have had an incredible impact. So the first project that we will be talking about is Healthcare for Transgenders, an initiative by fellows of Batch 170. Can I hear fellows from Batch 170, please? Who worked with the trans community to bring awareness on hepatitis C and broke the social stigma around it. They worked with local NGOs to support the trans community in Charsadda, Rawalpindi, and Peshawar. They were able to educate over 500 transgenders. The next project that we will be talking about is Dietitians on Board. This project was an initiative by fellows from Faisalabad. Can I hear Faisalabad? I cannot hear Faisalabad. They partnered with doctors from National Hospital Faisalabad and the pharmaceutical company NutriFactor and were successful in setting up 6 free medical camps for the underserved community. In batch 187, fellows combined their empathy with innovation and came up with an innovative solution to the unbearable heat of Karachi. They installed eco-coolers in slums around the city and made it possible for the local residents to enjoy a cooler breeze in the hot summer of Karachi. Then we have Sialkot. In Bash 205, where is Bash 205? In Bash 205, fellows felt a need to educate the young students in their rural area surrounding Sialkot. They saw an alarming rate of students falling out of school after intermediate. So they brought together their university friends and tried to educate the students about the opportunities that laid ahead of them. They were able to send over 50 students to university. Can we get a round of applause for them, please? In batch 190, an initiative named Khud Mukhtar set out to empower women, especially during the uncertain times of COVID. They became a bridge between the women and the market, helping them get orders, marketing their products, and providing adequate resources to them. Fellows from Bash 203, Lahore, where is Bash 203? I can't hear them. Fellows from Bash 203 put their engineering skills to use and came up with an idea to try and locally manufacture anti-riot shields. They partnered with Al Hadi Enterprises, a local equipment manufacturer, to supply 6 anti-riot shields and were successful in doing so. Last but not the least, we will be highlighting a project from Karachi
of fellows in batch 195 who partnered with Street to School, a school in Liaquatabad, to teach kids basic life skills that are generally overlooked otherwise. Their vision was to keep children out of the street and make them responsible citizens. It's ideas like these that inspire us to make a difference. I am so incredibly proud of all of you and cannot wait to see what you do next. All of you are capable of achieving wonderful things that you set your eye on, and that has been a proof through your AMIL fellowship. So dream big and good luck. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Haya. Thank you for such a powerful presentation. Actually, I remember when I was teaching, or you can say I was facilitating the session for my own batch, I remember that how above and beyond you all go to complete your mega projects, because that's an essence where you apply all of your skills, whether they are communication skills, whether they are your leadership skills, whether they are time management skills, because you do it along with your full-time jobs. Maybe some are doing part-time jobs, then along with your studies as well. So thank you so much for putting so much effort to create an impact in the society that will be for a very long time, that may change the life of maybe thousands of people, right? So I remember one quote from my own mentor and from the owner of school jahan se maine taleem hasil ki thi. He said ke beta ek bacche ki taleem aapne afford karni hai. Once you do that, once you educate just one child, then you will see that how much impact it will have in their coming generations. So all those who are teaching kids, who are providing healthcare, that's a huge round of applause for you, all of you. Now, before I move forward, I have just one question. Sirf ek sawal hai, chota sa, masoomana sa sawal hai. How many of you know Benji Williams? Can we make noise for Benji Williams?
Looks like Mr. Benji is known by so many in here.
So Benji might not be present with us here today. He is sitting thousands of miles from here. He is watching us. He can't be with us right now here, physically present here, but he has sent a very powerful message for you all. So I want all of you to please watch the video and listen to what Benji has to say to you. एज यू ऑल नो इट्स अबाउट टेक्नोलॉजी टेक्नोलॉजी हमेशा साथ नहीं देती है ठीक है सो इन द मीनवाइल द टेक्नोलॉजी इज अप वी विल हियर सम वर्ड्स फ्रॉम मिस्टर अली हु इज द सीईओ ऑफ अमल एकेडमी सो अली कैन यू प्लीज कम ऑन स्टेज एंड एड्रेस आवर फेलोज
A big round of applause for Mr. Ali Siddiq. Guys, shor kare, energy leke aaye.
अस्सलाम वालेकुम आवाज नहीं आई अस्सलाम वालेकुम ये चीज वंडरफुल टू सी सो मेनी स्माइलिंग फेसेस आई नो दैट ऑल ऑफ अस ऑल ऑफ यू डिड योर फेलोशिप ऑनलाइन एंड दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइम दैट यू गाइस आर मीटिंग इन पर्सन प्रैक्टिकली इन सच अ लार्ज गैदरिंग एंड इट्स जस्ट वंडरफुल टू सी एवरीबॉडी हियर इन लाहौर इन कराची इन पेशावर एंड ऑल्सो Everybody joining remotely through Facebook Live, welcome. And to all of our fellows, congratulations on this milestone accomplishment. What I'd like to do today is to share a story. Lekin usse pehle, just a few words of gratitude. First off, to our partners, PepsiCo, we have Mohammed Khosa, Hatim Khan and Anam Pasha here with us representing PepsiCo today. And all of us would probably not be here if it weren't for PepsiCo because they have enabled our program and our fellowship to scale across Pakistan. So a huge round of applause, please, for our partners, PepsiCo Pakistan and PepsiCo Foundation. And also, I'm very glad and delighted to announce that our chief guest, Dr. Faisal Bari, is also here with us. Dr. Faisal Bari, thank you so much. I'm looking forward to hearing you speak shortly. And last but not least, I'd like to thank the Amal team. The Amal team has been instrumental, as you all know, your program managers, your program associates, and also the admin team, the ops team on the back end that makes magic possible. And without them, I mean, those are the people that have facilitated each and every one of us to be able to get closer to our potential. So thank you very much, Amal team. Please, can we hear it for the Amal team?
Awesome.
All right. 1999 is the year when I was 18 years old. Aap logon se kuch, I was a bit younger than you guys. गाड़ी चलाने का बड़ा शौक था मुझे मुझे याद है वो रात आई वॉज सिटिंग इन माई इन आवर फैमिली कार एक 1982 की बीट अप टोयोटा करोला बेज कलर की डीजल कन्वर्टेड इंजन उसका पेशावर से हमने उसका इंजन कन्वर्ट करवाया था मैं गाड़ी में बैठा हुआ था रात का वक्त था आई वॉज ऑन द ड्राइवर सीट मेरे साथ वाली सीट पे मेरे वालिद साहब बैठे हुए थे और पिछली सीट पे मेरी अम्मी और दो बहनें बैठी हुई थी और हम एक शादी से वापस आ रहे थे रात तकरीबन 11 बजे का वक्त था लाहौर के माल रोड पे हम चल रहे थे और सामने मुझे एक मोटरसाइकिल्स का क्लस्टर नज़र आ रहा था जो थोड़ा अजीब सा एरेटिक तरीके से चल रहा था तो मैं जब उनके करीब पहुंचा और मोटरसाइकिलिस्ट के तो अंदाज़ा हुआ कि उस क्लस्टर के बीच में एक मोटरसाइकिल थी जिस पे एक बहन भाई एक लड़का और लड़की बैठे हुए थे लड़की जो है वो जिस तरह अक्सर खवातीन बैठती हैं साइड सैडल बैठी हुई थी और लड़का जो है शदीद सहमा हुआ था क्योंकि इर्द गिर्द जो तीन चार मोटरसाइकिलें थी वो हरास कर रहे थे उन दोनों को उस लड़की के बिल्कुल करीब उस बहन के बिल्कुल करीब मोटरसाइकिल लाना उनको कभी इधर से कट मारें आवाज़ें कसें और एक अजीब व गरीब किस्म की वो सूरत हाल थी जहाँ पर तीन चार लोग तीन चार मोटरसाइकिलिस्ट उस लड़के उस लड़की के पीछे थे और वो लड़का जो भाई था वो शदीद सहमा हुआ था कभी मोटरसाइकिल तेज़ करता था कभी राइट साइड पे जाता था कभी लेफ्ट पे आता था शदीद ख़तरनाक तरीके से वो चला रहा था क्या करता अभी भी मेरी रोंगटें खड़ी हो रही हैं आई रिमेंबर इट एज इट वॉज यस्टरडे 22 साल पुरानी बात है आई डिडंट थिंक मच, मैंने उसी वक्त गाड़ी डाउन शिफ्ट की, रेस लगाई, आगे निकला, जाके हॉर्न बजाया, एक को मैंने लेफ्ट साइड पे किसी तरीके से साइड पे करने की कोशिश की, अगले के जाके सामने ब्रेक जोर से लगाई, और मेरी अम्मी जो है वो पीछे से चिल्ला रही हैं, कह रही है अल्लाह अली पागल तो नहीं हो गए, पीछे बहने बैठी हुई हैं तुम्हारी, रात का वक्त है, क्या कर रहे हो? और मैं सोच रहा हूँ कि ये इस मोटरसाइकिल पे मैं भी तो हो सकता था और ये मेरी बहन भी तो हो सकती थी। और कुछ देर वो बाकी उन लोगों को साइड पे करके कुछ देर मैं मोटरसाइकिल चलाता रहा, मोटरसाइकिल के साथ अपनी गाड़ी चलाता रहा, उन लोगों को भी शायद थोड़ी तसल्ली हुई कि थोड़ी कामनेस आ गई है। लेकिन कुछ फासले के बाद मेरी टर्निंग आ गई, वो मोटरसाइकिल, वो बहन भाई आगे निकल गया और मैं लेफ्ट हो गया। और मुझे आज तक ये थोड़ा सा रिग्रेट है, थोड़ा सा नहीं है, मैं सोचता रहता हूँ इस बारे में कि मुझे प्रॉबेबली उन लोगों को घर तक छोड़ के आना चाहिए था। तो उस मौके पर किस्सा सुनाने का मकसद ये है कि उस मौके पर आई हैड अ चॉइस एंड मेरी चॉइस मेरे लिए बहुत आसान थी। मैंने अपने ज़मीर की आवाज़ सुनी, मैंने अपनी कॉन्शियस की आवाज़ सुनी और उसके मुताबिक मैंने अमल किया। और जो हम चॉइसेस जो है ना हमारे पास हर वक्त आती हैं, कुछ बड़ी होती हैं कुछ छोटी होती है, लेकिन इम्पोर्टेंट बात यह है कि उनमें से कोई भी चॉइस जो है ना वो इनकॉन्सिक्वेंशियल नहीं होती। हर चॉइस का एक, जो भी आप फैसला करते हैं, आप अपनी ज़मीर की आवाज़ सुनते हैं या नहीं सुनते, उसके मुताबिक फैसला करते हैं या नहीं करते, वो बाहर खारिज की दुनिया में तो इट मेक्स अ डिफरेंस, लेकिन आपके अंदर भी वो एक चेंज लेकर आती है। अगर आप छोटी छोटी चीज़ों पे एक अपने ज़मीर की आवाज़ सुने तो आपके लिए जिस वक्त एक मुश्किल फैसला आपके सामने आएगा तो वो भी आपके लिए आसान होगा अपनी ज़मीर की आवाज़ के मुताबिक, अपने कॉन्शियंस के मुताबिक फैसला करना। और बात यह है कि आई एम ऑल्सो पार्ट ऑफ दिस, हम सब जो हैं वो हमेशा अपने ज़मीर के मुताबिक नहीं फैसला करते, हमेशा जब चॉइसेस आते हैं तो नहीं हम उस तरह करते। फॉर एग्जाम्पल आज सुबह की मिसाल लें, आज सुबह सोचें जिस वक्त आप वॉशरूम में खड़े दांत साफ कर रहे थे तो आप में से कितनों ने नलका बंद किया, कितनों ने नलका बंद किया कि जी फिर से नलका चलाएंगे? मुझे पता है सो कुछ लोग हाथ खड़ा कर रहे हैं, दैट्स एक्सेलेंट, बट मेनी ऑफ अस डोंट एंड वी रियलाइज कि हमारे ग्लेशियर्स पिघल रहे हैं, पानी का फुकदान है, हमें पता है हमारी एग्रीकल्चरल सोसाइटी है दुनिया में का, लेकिन हम वो छोटी सी एक चीज़ नहीं करते हैं। इसी तरह मेरे साथ होता है, अक्सर होता है, आई एम श्योर मैनी ऑफ यू कैन रिलेट, रात को आप गर्म होके रजाई में कंबल में बेड में बैठे हुए हैं और आपको याद आता है कि यार बाहर बरामदे की दो बत्तियां जल रही हैं, लेकिन कितने हम में से जो कि अपने आप को डिसकम्फर्ट दे के बाहर निकल के तो बत्ती बंद करने जाते हैं, राइट? सो हम क्यों नहीं करते, हम सोचते हैं कि यार एक बंदे के करने से क्या फ़र्क पड़ जाएगा, एक बत्ती बंद करने से क्या फ़र्क पड़ जाएगा, पानी थोड़ी देर बंद कर लेने से क्या फ़र्क पड़ जाएगा, मैंने कौन सा ग्लेशियर बचा लेना है? लेकिन द पॉइंट इज दैट ईच लिटिल थिंग मेक्स अ डिफरेंस। अगर एक 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 बंदे के कुछ ना करने से कुछ फ़र्क नहीं पड़ेगा तो अगर हमें ये सोचना चाहिए उसके बरक्स कि अगर हम में से हर एक बंदा वो छोटा सा एक स्टेप ले जो हमें पता है व्हाट इज़ राइट एंड व्हाट इज़ रॉन्ग, राइट के मुताबिक अगर फैसला करे तो क्या हम एक सी चेंज नहीं लेकर आ सकते? जब कतरा कतरा बन के एक तूफान बनता है, एक दरिया बनता है, एक समंदर बनता है, एक सैलाब बनता है, तो क्या हम नहीं वो कर सकते? बिल्कुल, हमारे पास ये कैपेबिलिटी है, हमारे पास ये पोटेंशियल है कि हम सही फैसला करें, अपने ज़मीर के मुताबिक फैसला करें। एंड वन अदर थिंग आईड लाइक टू से इज दैट All of us here are incredibly privileged. हमें पता भी है कि acts of kindness आप लोगों ने fellowship में भी किए हैं, आप लोगों ने ईदी के लिए 50 लाख रुपया जमा किया, आपको पता है आपके पास capability है, आप जब इकट्ठे होते हैं तो आप एक सैलाब ला सकते हैं change का, आप दूसरों को inspire कर सकते हैं, right? So हमारे पे एक मजीद ज़्यादा because of the knowledge that we have that gives us power and that gives us an additional responsibility कि हम action लें। So मेरा आप लोगों से ये गुजारिश है, ये कॉल टू एक्शन है आपके लिए कि पाकिस्तान जो है ना वो एक चौराहे पर नहीं है, दोराहे पे नहीं है, उसे आगे निकल गया हुआ है। और हमारी हर एक की रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है कि हम जो कुछ कर सकें, छोटी सी छोटी चीज़, बड़ी सी बड़ी चीज़, वो हम करें। We don't stand by idle by the wayside when we see something that shouldn't be the way that it is. We do something about it. Meri call to action aap sab se ye hai ki for example raat ko jab aap kisi chowk pe pahunchte hain aur batti yellow hai ya red hai और कोई ट्रैफिक नहीं है, आप रोके वहां पे अपनी गाड़ी। मेरी कॉल टू एक्शन आप लोगों से ये है कि जिस वक्त आपको नजर आए कि किसी ने गाड़ी से बाहर कूड़ा फेंका है या सड़क पे कूड़ा पड़ा हुआ है, तो ये नहीं कि आप सिर्फ दूसरे को मना करें, आप वो उठा लें। आपको देखा देखी और लोग इंस्पायर होंगे, आप सब के पास ये पावर है कि ये आप कर सकते हैं। मेरी कॉल टू एक्शन ये है आपसे कि जिस वक्त आपके व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप्स पे, आपके दोस्तों के व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप पे कोई फजूलियात बकी जाती है, कोई फजूल नेगेटिव किस्म की वीडियो शेयर की जाती है, कोई किसी माइनॉरिटी के बुरा भला कहता है, डोंट स्टे साइलेंट, डू व्हाट यू नीड टू डू, बिकॉज हमारा मुल्क उस चौराहे से आगे निकल चुका है, हमने वापस आना है, हमने दूसरा रास्ता पकड़ना है, हमने कोर्स करेक्ट करना है, और हम सबकी ये रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है कि हम ये करें। और ये कब करने का वक्त है, ये बातें तो बड़ी अच्छी लगती हैं, लेकिन जिस तरह मैंने कहा, हम द टाइम टू एक्ट इज नाउ। आज आप क्या करेंगे? सो मैं आप लोगों से ये रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा कि एवरीबॉडी दैट्स हियर टुडे, एवरीबॉडी दैट्स इन पेशावर, दैट्स इन कराची, दैट्स व्यूइंग रिमोटली, दैट्स हियर इन लाहौर, हमारे इर्द गिर्द इस वक्त तकरीबन 2000 लोग हम जमा हुए हैं। यहाँ से बाहर निकलेंगे, कुछ लोगों को शायद रास्ता नहीं मिल रहा होगा। You know, like, what is it that you can do? Can you do a small kind act of kindness today? Can you start developing that muscle that you need, that this country needs, that our future needs just now? Aaj din ke end pe, for example, sochein ki aap kya kuch kar sakte hain. Din ke end pe aapko, inshallah, snack boxes milenge, dinner boxes milenge. Just ground this call to action in that right there. Will you be responsible in terms of making sure we don't leave this place messy? Will you be responsible in terms of, is this something you can do? Ki ji, agar aapko gun nazar aa raha hai, to aap utha ke khud usko trash receptacle mein daalein. Choti choti cheeze hain jo ki aap kar sakte hain, right? Hum bahar nikalte hain, gate pe guard hai, aap bahar nikalte hain, traffic police wala hai, aap bahar nikalte hain, mali paudon ko pani de raha hai, usko salam kar lein, uska haal chaal pooch lein. Choti choti cheeze hain, ye wahi cheeze hain jo ki is mulk ko behtar banayengi, humko behtar banayengi, kyunki jis tarah maine kaha, jis tarah bahar ki duniya mein, kharij ki duniya mein aapke amal karne se kuch element चेंज होता है, आपके अंदर आपके दिल में भी आपका जो ज़मीर है, आपका जो इनर मोरल कंपस है, वो भी स्ट्रांग होता है। आई नो आई एम प्रीचिंग टू द क्वायर, आप सारे के सारे जो हैं, यू आर ऑलरेडी सोशली रिस्पॉन्सिबल, यू आर ऑलरेडी प्राइंग फॉर दिस, बट वी ऑल हैव अ रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी, एंड आई जस्ट वॉन्टेड टू रिमाइंड यू कि जी द टाइम टू एक्ट इज नाउ। थैंक यू सो मच, गॉड स्पीड, बेस्ट ऑफ लक, कंग्रेचुलेशंस वंस अगेन ऑन योर on being who you are and continuing this journey of lifelong learning and impact. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Ali, for saying that. And I remember someone saying that you don't need PhDs to be kind, right? अगर आपको वाक्य में ही काइंड बनना है तो इसके लिए जरूरी नहीं है यू हैव अ ट्रांसक्रिप्ट जिसके ऊपर लिखा हो यू हैव पीएचडी टू बी काइंड, राइट? वेरी वेरी स्मॉल एक्ट्स ऑफ काइंडनेस, मे बी जस्ट अ स्माइल टू द पर्सन हु इज स्टैंडिंग राइट नेक्स्ट टू यू इज एन एक्ट ऑफ काइंडनेस, बिकॉज यू डोंट नो दैट मे बी दैट लिटिल स्माइल विल चेंज द वे दैट पर्सन इज विल फील इन द नेक्स्ट मोमेंट, राइट? सो इट्स वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू बी काइंड टू अदर्स, टू फील व्हाट अदर्स आर गोइंग थ्रू. So thank you so much, Ali, for saying that. And as Ali has said, yes, you will be getting some snacks at the end of this graduation ceremony. So just be kind enough to just take your boxes and throw them in the dustbin, rather than ke aap wahin pe bahar phenk ke chale jaye, just find a designated place and throw them there. Before any further delay, I would like to call and I would like to introduce our guests for today. And with us is Dr. Faisal Bari, who is serving as Dean of Lahore Lums School of Education at Lums. Sir, can you please come on stage? From PepsiCo, we are joined by Director of Public Policy and Government Affairs, Mr. Hatim Khan, and Senior Director of Sales and Corporate Affairs, Mr. Mohammed Khosa. So can you please come on stage? And then CEO of Amal Academy, Mr. Muhammad Ali Siddiq. So please kindly take your seats. And how can we keep Benji out of this graduation ceremony? हम बेंजी को बाहर कैसे रख सकते हैं, राइट? सो फाइनली द वीडियोस अप एंड बिफोर वी मूव टू आवर गेस्ट, सो लेट्स वॉच व्हाट बेंजी हैज टू से टू आवर ग्रेजुएटिंग बैचेस.
Assalamu alaikum, Amo fellows. I hope you are all feeling incredibly excited to be graduating from the fellowship today. I am certainly beyond proud of each one of you and the journey that you have been on. And wanted to share a few things that hopefully might be an encouragement for what lies ahead in your journey. As many of you know, I have been working on a forest restoration project for the last couple of years now, and the progress has been pretty slow at times. And so I have been spending some time thinking about why that is and wanted to share what I've been learning. Earlier this year, I had a chance to return to my Grandma Ollie's ancestral village in Eudora, Arkansas. Many of you will remember her from the fellowship and her famous line, "Whether you think you can or think you cannot, you are right." And I've been thinking about this line and about my grandmother, who I never really had a chance to meet. She passed away when I was only a few months old. And so I hopped in the car, drove 2,500 kilometers across the country, and pulled up in this very rural countryside town of about 4,000, 5,000 people, just 5 miles or so west of Mississippi, 7 miles or so north of Louisiana, along the great Mississippi River Delta. And the purpose of my visit was really to try and understand my grandparents more. They grew up in that town. They had to pick cotton in that town. They graduated from that town and then they left and they never returned. And I wanted to know what happens when you never return to a place and what is lost by that exodus and can any of it be regained? And so I drove around that town, I walked around that town, I talked to the people, I went across the train tracks that kind of segregated the town. On one side is where the black people used to live, on the other is where the white people lived. I went to the school that was where my grandparents studied. It's closed down, but the building is still there. It was called the Eudora Colored High School, which was a segregated school where only the black students went. I saw the fields that they picked cotton from as sharecroppers, really against their will, but they had no choice. I saw the church that they most likely went to, called Mount Zion Baptist. And I talked to the people there. But ultimately, I didn't have really any epiphanies, any ahas. And so I left. I came back here to New York. I wrote about them. I thought about them. And here's what I ultimately am discovering, that the work of forest restoration in many ways depends on my own restoration with the land and my own ability to sort of heal from some of the past trauma and the history, the complex history that I and my family have had with the land. And this is a surprising insight for me because there are so many people that have complex histories with land. In many ways, we've been extracting from the land. We have been taking land that isn't ours for centuries. And we're in a pretty terrible situation regarding climate change and the environment. And it's confusing to me how we allowed that to happen. And so what I realized for my own project and perhaps even for the greater climate change effort is that we really need to, and I really need to, restore my own relationship with the land and my history with the land in order to then try and help restore the forest and protect the forest. And so the application or the insight for each of you in the fellowship is to really encourage you to continue that work of self-introspection and self-healing and self-growth, that we can only try and help others after or while we're helping ourselves. And whether it's focusing on your mental health, your physical health, your sort of journey as a lifelong learner, whatever it might be, I want to encourage you to continue investing in yourself in that way, even as you leave the fellowship, because the stronger you are, the more you'll be able to help people around you. And oftentimes it's when we get so caught up in trying to help everyone else that we lose sight of who it is that we are. And so I wanted to share my own personal journey in order to say that I am on the path with each one of you. I am walking alongside of you. And in many ways, your progress is interlinked to mine. And so I am certainly wishing you Godspeed. I am incredibly proud of all the progress that you've made. And I feel very hopeful about what lies ahead for all of us. Congratulations again, Bahot Mubarak, and Assalamu Alaikum. Hope to see you soon, inshallah.
Now that was a very powerful message sent miles away from Mr. Benji. As shared by Ms. Haya earlier, PepsiCo Pakistan has been a constant support for Amal Academy and our spectacular fellows. Before requesting our esteemed guests to share their reflections, we'd like to play a short video compilation of Amal fellows talking about how they've gone through this fellowship experience. Can we please have the video played?
We are PepsiCo Amal Career Fellows.
Batch 165.
Batch 172.
Batch number 173.
Batch 181.
Batch 181.
Batch 184.
From Batch 206.
Batch number 206.
We are part of PepsiCo supported 3 months fellowship program to develop professional skills needed for your successful career and life.
The program equipped us with the tools and skills to kickstart our professional career.
We improved our soft skills and learned how to thrive in a digital environment.
We acquired so many new skills through this fellowship thanks to PepsiCo and Amal.
Confidence, public speaking, leadership skills,
job preparation, entrepreneurship skills, and resume building.
This was a life-changing decision, and we were encouraged to become lifelong learners.
We're building our dreams,
launching our careers,
and becoming a better version of ourselves.
A big round of applause for our supporters, PepsiCo Pakistan. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Mr. Mohammad Khosa, Senior Director, Sales and Corporate Affairs at PepsiCo, with a big round of applause. Mr. Mohammad Khosa.
Ji, assalamu alaikum everyone. Just okay. Ji, assalamu alaikum everyone. How are you? So Lahore, Peshawar, Karachi, and Faisalabad. So have I missed out anyone? All these cities are there. Okay, thank you so much. First of all, thank you so much to Ali for inviting me and giving me this privilege. I think जब ये प्रोग्राम तीन एक साल पहले शुरू हुआ था जो नीश ढूंढना चाह रहे थे हम सारे वो यही थे कि फ्रॉम पेप्सी के एंगल से भी हम लोग म्यूजिक एंड यूथ यूज्ड टू बी समथिंग क्रिकेट एंड यूथ यूज्ड टू बी समथिंग बट real substantive, let's say, more than arts ke alawa, logon ki value mein kya addition, zindagiyon mein kya value addition ho sakti hai. I must say that Benji and Ali really, really were instrumental in coming up with this concept, which is unique right now. I think logon ka bahut zyada focus technical skills ke upar hota hai, computer science, engineering, vocational training. But really, जो कुछ life skills होती हैं, जो जो आपको आगे लेके जाती हैं, हमने पहले बहुत ज़्यादा उसके ऊपर काम नहीं देखा था. And really, really, I feel very proud that I think over 5,000 graduates have gone out of this program in the last few years. That said, what I want to do today, apart from you know really, really congratulating you, is as everybody has shared some of my own learnings in life, since a lot of you are right now at that cusp, log aakhri saal apne college ke usme hain, aage aap jobs dhoond rahe honge, kuch already jobs kar rahe hain jo careers mein aage jaane ki koshish kar rahe honge. So just a few ideas which I thought if I knew 20 years ago when I was starting out my career. So number one for me is, you know, aapka jo career hai wo kabhi bhi ek straight line nahi hogi. Your career will never be a straight line. कि जी आज मैं इंजीनियर हूं, मैं ये जॉब करूंगा, फिर अगले दो साल बाद मेरी प्रमोशन हो जाएगी, फिर मैं दूसरी जॉब करूंगा, इस तरह मेरी एक साइकिल चलती रहेगी. इट्स नेवर लाइक दैट रियलिस्टिकली. रियलिस्टिकली व्हाट हैपेंस इज दैट आपको अपने आप को एक्सपीरियंसेस के ऊपर फ्रीक्वेंटली मूव करना पड़ता है. आई हैव चेंज्ड आई थिंक इन द लास्ट 12 इयर्स, मुझे अब पेप्सिको में हो गए हैं, मैंने 6 से 7 डिफरेंट रोल्स किए हैं 12 साल के अंदर, और हर उस पर एक रिस्क लेना पड़ा है क्योंकि कंफर्ट जोन से मैं कभी पब्लिक अफेयर्स के अंदर होता था, कभी सेल्स में होता था, कभी ब्रांड्स में होता था, फाइनेंस का भी आइडिया हुआ. सो वन ऑफ माय लर्निंग्स रियली इज अपस्किल योरसेल्फ ऑलवेज. ये ग्रेजुएशन सेरेमनी हो जाएगी, ये खत्म हो जाएगा प्रोग्राम आज का, बट अपस्किलिंग योरसेल्फ एंड इट हैज टू बी अ कॉन्शियस एफर्ट. इट कैन नॉट बी कि जी मैं किसी प्रोग्राम मिलेगा मुझे तो मैं कर लूंगा. I think that's the spirit जो अमल ने भी inculcate आपके अंदर करने की कोशिश की है throughout this thing. I think the other very important one for me is I think moving on from that is self awareness. बहुत सारे लोग, मैं आपको सच्ची बात बताऊं, very few people are self aware. We think that we are self aware. And imagine if you were to believe that you are not self aware, then half the time we'd be lying to ourselves. एंड उस चीज में से किस तरह निकलना है इज अ वेरी वेरी की कंपोनेंट ऑफ लाइफ. अमूमन हम सवाल करते हैं कि जी व्हाई एम आई डूइंग दिस, व्हाई डिड दिस हैपन टू मी. इन माई लाइफ आई फाउंड इट मच मच इजियर, बिकॉज व्हाई इज मोर लाइक अ यू नो रियर व्यू मिरर. नाउ इट्स गुड टू रिफ्लेक्ट, इट्स गुड टू सी व्हाट हैपेंड, but if you over analyze it, data suggests it can even be you know cause more anxiety and more depression even at times. So in my life what helped me was the word what. Rather than keep asking why did this happen to me, I would ask what did I want out of this, or what is it. And I can share you examples, you know, some very serious ones. Friend of mine had cancer, and there was a time period jahan bar 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 mere saath kyun hota, ek self pity ke aap angle mein chale jaate hain. But when she started thinking that, okay, what is important for me? Why did this happen is not the big question. But what do I need to do to get out of this is when it pushes you forward. Similarly, multiple, I had a friend who used to hate his job. Ki yaar, mujhe bilkul naukri ye pasand nahi hai. Lekin rather than just sitting there doing nothing about it, once he started questioning, ki, okay, what is it that I want? What are circumstances that suit me? How will I get out of this? That is when you start moving forward, really. I think third thing that I have learned over time is authenticity. Be real. Be just na Ali baat kar rahe the ke it's very difficult being real in today's world. You have so many voices telling you what you should be like, and it takes courage and determination to be yourself and be authentic. But trust me, you will feel it yourself that when you are being authentic yourself, things will happen for you automatically, because aapki genuineness jo hai usme se nikal ke aa rahi hogi. I think the other thing which is very very important again, which I have learned, is a skill which I call grace under fire, because everybody will have fire under their feet at different points in time. And that really for me is the difference between a powerful mind and a powerless mind. And that you guys should look at, read about it, read what is a powerful mind and what is a powerless mind. How do winners think? What is the thin line between confidence and arrogance? All of those winners generally are more assertive. They are more optimistic. They think more about whatever the challenge, they think they will do it. But sometimes talk is cheap as well. So you have to really, really balance. And ye cheeze zyada test hoti hain jab aap pressure mein hote hain. Aapki asal jo personality hai wo ubhar ke aati hai ya niche jaati hai pressure ke andar. So put yourself under pressure. Analyze how you were under pressure whenever you were put under pressure. And that, I think, is one of my biggest learnings over time. And lastly, I think more of a professional advice, which we don't do a lot, I feel, is really cultivate your networks. I think sometimes hum sochte hain ki yaar ye pata nahi achhi cheez hai, taluk banana achha hai ya nahi hai. Koi kahega nahi yaar ye to koi sifarish ke through ye cheez ho gayi hai. But reality of the matter is your networks across your life, throughout your life, it is human nature that people who know you better will probably end up trusting you better. So there has to be conscious effort both internally, aapki apni organizations mein hai, idaron mein hai, jahan bhi hai. Aap wahan bhi apne networks banaye, balki aap apne idaron se bahar jaake bhi apne networks banaye. And you know, universities and colleges are great places to do that. And now that you transition into companies, I can tell you there are many, many forums where you will be able to do that. And just as I wrap it up, honestly, you know, really, really proud to be here. Congratulations once again. I think this is one of the best programs that we work with Amal on. And I hope that with some of the internees that we had as well, we were able to give you a very good insight into how both personally and professionally one can work. So thank you very much and enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Mohammad Khosa. That was certainly very inspirational. I am now going to request Mr. Hatim Khan to please come on stage and share his reflections with all of us. Hey, Bilana.
Assalamu alaikum everyone. This is very surprising for me that I have to speak right now. So I literally had a 5-second notice to speak here. So I'll be really short, obviously, because I haven't prepared anything. All I want to say is, you know, we started, I think, 3 years ago. We met Benji and Ali, like Mohammed said, and they presented this fantastic idea that, you know, there's a way to bridge the gap between the academia and the industry is to develop the professional skills of university graduates. As unemployment rate was rising, while and employers like PepsiCo and many others were saying that students have great technical successes or expertise, but you know the professional skills are generally something that they need to catch up on. So for me, I'm really proud to see that this is the third year, over 2,000 students have graduated. So the PepsiCo Amal partnership is 5,000 students old. And we feel really proud when we look at your mega projects, you know, the great work that you do. We feel really proud when you get jobs, you know, because it really resonates with the DNA of PepsiCo. We want to, you know, we want to work with the communities where we operate. We want to work for the planet. And it is completely in line with what you do. So I won't take any more time, but really many, many congratulations. Wishing you all the best. A lot of students, by the way, from Amal Academy come to work as internees in PepsiCo. So I hope we can also continue that journey. Next year, we can see many of you as internees in the Kamyab Jawan program in PepsiCo. So all the best in your career ahead. Thank you.
Thank you, Hatem. Actually, this was the gist that we wanted to show you. कि हम भी अपने फेलोज को बहुत सरप्राइज करते हैं. वो ये सोच के आते हैं फेलोशिप जो होगी बहुत आप कहें फन करेंगे, एंजॉय करेंगे, एंड देन द फर्स्ट डे दे कम एंड वी जस्ट गिव देम द वर्क लोड दैट दे हैव टू गो थ्रू, एंड देन वी सरप्राइज देम एक्चुअली इन अ पॉजिटिव मैनर एज वेल. दिस इज अ पॉजिटिव एज वेल. वो ऐसे होता है कि ये सोच के आते हैं दीज क्लासेस वुड बी लाइक यूनिवर्सिटी क्लासेस, टीचर्स आएंगे, पढ़ाएंगे और चले जाएंगे, बट दैट्स नॉट हाउ वी कंडक्ट आवर क्लासेस, राइट? ऐसा ही है कि हम यूनिवर्सिटी की तरह क्लासेस लेते हैं? नहीं, अगर है तो आप बता दें, अनेस्टली बता दें, ठीक है? सो दीज क्लासेस आर नॉट लाइक यूनिवर्सिटी क्लासेस. वी आर लाइक बिकम देयर फ्रेंड्स एंड टीच देम द हाउ दे नीड टू बी इन द प्रोफेशनल लाइफ. सो विदाउट एनी फर्दर डिले, आई वुड लाइक यू टू इंट्रोड्यूस द चीफ गेस्ट ऑफ टूडे, डॉक्टर फैसल बारी. डॉक्टर फैसल बारी इज the dean of LUMS School of Education. He is also serving as associate professor of economics. He has deep interest in game theory, microeconomics, and economics of education.
So Vikas, you seem to know quite a lot about Dr. Faisal Bari. Have you ever had the chance to interact with him before?
Hajra, main aapko batau, sir, I used to be aapki aankhon ka tara, right? जी जी, मैं सर बारी की आंखों का तारा रह चुका हूँ, राइट? और अभी भी हूँ, एंड आई कैन प्राउडली से, एंड डॉक्टर बारीज क्लासेस एट लम्स यूज्ड टू बी वन ऑफ द बेस्ट क्लास दैट आई हैव पर्सनली गॉन थ्रू. इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ डॉक्टर फैसल बारी दैट आई स्टेप्ड इनटू एजुकेशन सेक्टर राइट आफ्टर गेटिंग डिग्री, राइट आफ्टर गेटिंग डिग्री इन मैनेजमेंट साइंसेज. एंड आई रिमेंबर माई फर्स्ट क्लास विद हिम, दैट वॉज अबाउट गेम थ्योरी. And I went into the class. I saw Dr. Bari there, and I thought कि अच्छा बहुत boring class होने वाली है. But then he started using the examples from his daily life, from his own experiences, and from the experience जिसे हम लोग रोजाना जाते हैं. And those were the examples जो कि किताबों में मुझे आज तक नहीं मिली, क्योंकि हमेशा वो किताबों में आपको बहुत पुरानी example दी जाती हैं. So without any further delay, I would request him to please address our fellows and share a few words from his vast experience. Dr. Bari.
Assalamu alaikum ji. Aap sab ka bahut shukriya. Badi der se baithe hain, bade tahammul se sun rahe hain. It's a pleasure to be here and an honor to be able to see you all, and someday I hope to make better acquaintance of at least some of you. Pichle 30 saal se main takriban padha raha hu, aur in 30 saalon mein ye jo moment hai na graduation ka, ye hamesha is the most fun moment. वजह उसकी ये है कि इट्स बोथ अ बिगिनिंग एंड इट इज एन एंड. इट्स एन एंड टू द प्रोग्राम दैट यू वर डूइंग, बट इट्स अ बिगिनिंग टू अ लॉट ऑफ न्यू थिंग्स दैट यू शुड बी थिंकिंग अबाउट. बहुत सारी चीज, जो कुछ सीखा है वो कहाँ जाएगा, उसको कैसे इस्तेमाल करना. फैज अहमद फैज साहब ने फरमाया था, शिकवाए जुल्मते शब से तो कहीं बेहतर था. शिकवाए जुल्मते शब से तो कहीं बेहतर था अपने हिस्से की कोई शम्मा जलाते जाते. ये शम्मा क्या है कि रात की के अंधेरे का गिला करने की बजाय आप अपने हिस्से की शम्मा जलाइए. ये शम्मा क्या है, इसमें दो चीजें ख्याल रखनी है. शमा रोशनी भी बिखेरती है, और शमा ये नहीं देखती कि ये रोशनी किसको जा रही है. सो रिमेंबर, आपको जो कुछ भी मिला है ये आपका नहीं है, ये आपके पास अमानत है उन लोगों की जिनके लिए अब आपने ये काम करना है. जो कुछ मिला है आपने इसको आगे देना। मेरे एक बुजुर्ग होते थे, और लोगों के भी बहुत बुजुर्ग रहे हैं वो, उन्होंने फरमाया था पंजाबी में कि तुसी की गल कर रहे हो, दित्ते तो देना होता है ना, यानी जो आपको मिला है उसी में से आप आगे दे रहे हैं ना, तो इसमें खास बात क्या है? अपने तक रखना खयानत है, आगे देना सिर्फ आप उनका हिस्सा उसको दे रहे हैं जिसको ये हिस्सा पहुंचना चाहिए था। आप एक जरिया हैं, और ये ख्याल रखिएगा कि जरिया बनना बहुत जरूरी है अब आपके लिए, क्योंकि अब ये आपकी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी आ गई है, और इस रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी से बचना बहुत मुश्किल होगा। हमारे कुछ और साथियों ने भी ये बात की थी लाइफ लॉन्ग लर्निंग की। हम इस हॉल में हैं जहां हमारे ऊपर अलामा साहब की तस्वीर है, उन्हीं का एक शेर है, मुझे याद आया उस पर उन्होंने फरमाया था, और ये आप अपनी घुट्टी में बांध लें, घुट्टी समझते हैं ना, इंटरनलाइज कर लीजिए इसको। राजे हयात पूछ ले खिजर खजिस्ता गाम से, खिजर हजरत खिजर अलैहिस्सलाम का जिक्र कि वो रहेंगे टाइम काफी। राजे हयात पूछ ले एक ऐसे बंदे से भी जिसकी लाइफ बहुत लंबी है, खिजर खजिस्ता गाम से, हु वॉक्स लाइट फुटेड, एज इन उनका बहुत इम्प्रिंट बड़ा हल्का होता है ऑन टाइम। जिंदा हर एक चीज है कोशिशें ना तमाम से, देर इज नेवर नेवर एन एंड टू वेयर यू वॉन्ट टू बी, वॉट यू वॉन्ट टू बी, वॉट यू वॉन्ट टू डू, क्योंकि वो जो अगर कोशिश तमाम हो गई तो वो फिर एंड भी हो गया। इसी को वो बड़ा अच्छा ऑथर है ना, जिसने उसको, उसकी किताब है अनबेरेबल लाइटनेस ऑफ बीइंग, उसमें उसने इसको समोया था। वो किताब पढ़ लीजिए या लामा साहब का ये शेर समझ लीजिए, बात एक ही है कि वो एफर्ट क्या है। अच्छा, मैं आपको थोड़ा सा ये जरूर कहूंगा कि सोचिए मेरे साथ, गो बैक इन टाइम, आप लोगों के 20 साल 25 साल जितना भी है, मेरे थोड़े ज्यादा हैं आपसे काफी ज्यादा, लेकिन हु आर द रिमार्केबल पीपल दैट यू रिमेंबर, रिमार्केबल टीचर्स, रिलेटिव्स, पेरेंट्स, जो भी आपकी जिंदगी में जिसे आप रिमार्केबल समझते हैं वो कौन थे? जब मैं पीछे देखता हूं ना, तो मुझे अपनी जिंदगी में जो लोग जिनके साथ, जिनको मैं रिमार्केबल कहूंगा, उनमें कुछ चीजें मुझे कुछ कदरें बड़ी मुश्तरक लगती हैं। देयर कमिटमेंट, कमिटमेंट टू समथिंग, जिस पे मिर्जा गालिब ने कहा था ना, वफादारी बशर्ते उस्तवारी असले ईमान है। ईमान की असल क्या है? वफादारी बशर्ते उस्तवारी, वफादारी का कायम रहना उस कमिटमेंट का जिस चीज से आपने कमिट किया। और वो क्या कहते हैं अगले मिसरे में, मरे बुतखाने में तो गाड़ो, तो काबे में गाड़ो ब्राह्मण को, के मरे बुतखाने, अपने कमिटमेंट से अगर कायम है वो बंदा, तो गिव हिम द रिस्पेक्ट दैट यू नीड टू गिव एवरी इंडिविजुअल जो अपने कमिटमेंट पे रहा है। मरे बुतखाने में तो काबे में गाड़ो ब्राह्मण को, अगर वो वफादारी बशर्ते उस्तवारी असले ईमान पे रहा है। सो ये जो कमिटमेंट है ना उन लोगों का जिनकी मैं बात कर रहा हूं, जो आप रिमार्केबल समझते हैं, आई थिंक दैट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू कीप इन माइंड, वेरी स्ट्रॉन्ग कमिटमेंट जो भी आपका है, क्रिकेट खेलनी है, कुछ करना है, ऑब्सेस होके करना है, ताकि उसमें ब्रिलियंस तभी आएगी। डंग टक पाओ काम करेंगे आप, जिसे जुगाड़ कहते हैं हम लोग, तो फिर बात नहीं बनेगी। सो वो कमिटमेंट आपने अपने निकालना है, और उसमें साल भी लगेंगे, उसमें मेहनत भी आएगी, उसमें वन स्टेप फॉरवर्ड टू बैकवर्ड्स भी होगा, बट दैट्स द नेचर ऑफ लर्निंग, दैट्स द नेचर ऑफ लिविंग। किसकी जिंदगी में ये नहीं हुआ? किसकी जिंदगी, चाहे नबी अलैहिस्सलाम लें, चाहे आम आदमी लें, सबकी जिंदगी में ये स्ट्रगल है, उसके बगैर आप सोना नहीं बन सकते। शेयरिंग, जितने रिमार्केबल लोग आपकी जिंदगी में थे, टीचर, पेरेंट्स, कुछ भी हैं, उनमें एक कदर मुश्तरक है कि वो सेल्फिश नहीं होते, वो शेयर करते हैं, वो जो चीज दे सकते हैं वो देते हैं, जिस तरह दे सकते हैं देते हैं। आपने अपने असातिज़ा के इल्म से इस्तफादा किया है, आपने अपने माँ बाप बहन भाई दोस्त के प्यार से, उनके कोऑपरेशन से, इससे इस्तफादा किया। दैट्स अ क्वालिटी, इट हैज टू बी देयर, क्योंकि मैंने जैसे कहा पहले, जो आपको दिया गया है, जो चाहे वो पैसा है, रिसोर्स है, आपके आज़ा हैं, जो भी चीज है, अमानत के तौर पे दिया गया है, जो आगे जानी जानी है। शेयरिंग इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, जेनरोसिटी उसके साथ आती है। दिल खोल के दीजिए, दिल खोल के लोगों के साथ मिलिए, दिल खोल के उनसे डील कीजिए। इंसान वो, आपने अभी नारा भी लगाया था ना, एक और एक 11, तो एक और एक 111, 1011, क्यों नहीं? यही तो इंसान की सिफ्त है कि हमारी लिमिट्स वो हैं जो हमारी अपनी लिमिट्स हम बनाते हैं। सो दिल बड़ा कीजिए लोगों के साथ मिलने में, उनके साथ मिल के काम करने में, तो आपको उससे ज्यादा मिलेगा। जो आप ये समझते हैं कि अगर मैं दिल छोटा रखूंगा तो जो मिलेगा आपको उससे, वो ये सारे लोग जो जिनकी मैं बात सोच रहा हूं, वो कभी अपने आप में फोकस नहीं रहे। उन्होंने कभी इस तरह नहीं सोचा कि मेरे लिए क्या इंपॉर्टेंट है। सिर्फ हम के सीगे में सोचते हैं, एक बंदा रेस जीत भी जाए तो क्या है। बात तो तभी है ना जब सारे मंजिल की तरफ जा सकें, मंजिल पे पहुंच सकें। इन तमाम लोगों में ये सारी क्वालिटीज होनी पड़ेंगी तो फिर ही कोई रिमार्केबल बनता है। आप सोचिएगा, एक किताब बड़ी अच्छी गुड जेफ ने लिखी थी, वो शायद उसका टाइटल ही था मीटिंग्स विद रिमार्केबल पीपल, और आप वो किताब भी देखिए तो उसमें ये सारी क्वालिटीज जो मैं बात कर रहा हूँ, कमिटमेंट, शेयरिंग, जेनरोसिटी, जेनरोसिटी ऑफ स्पिरिट, एक ओपननेस टू न्यू एक्सपीरियंस, टू लर्निंग, इसके बगैर आपकी ग्रोथ कहीं ना कहीं रुक जाएगी। और वो जो पहले कहा गया, ना सेल्फ अवेयरनेस आएगी, ना आपको एहसास होगा कि क्या, किस मकसद के लिए आप जिंदगी गुजारना चाह रहे हैं। वो बहुत जरूरी है कि ये क्वालिटीज आप अपने आप में इनकलकेट कीजिए। आज ये फैसला, अली ने बड़ी अच्छी बात की थी कि कब से शुरू करना है। नई चीज शुरू करने का वक्त कब होता है? अब होता है, आज होता है। हमारे लिए यही तो एक बड़ा मजेदार बात होती है कि एवरी मोमेंट कैन बी अ मोमेंट ऑफ अ न्यू बिगिनिंग, कैन बी अ मोमेंट ऑफ रिक्रिएटिंग योर सेल्फ इन वॉट यू वॉन्ट टू बी, एंड दैट इज अ मोमेंट दैट यू हैव टू सीज फॉर यूर। हु डू यू वॉन्ट टू बी? मेरे एक उस्ताद होते थे, उन्होंने हमें PhD का एक कोर्स पढ़ाया था, तो उन्होंने हमसे कहा था कोर्स में एनरोलमेंट की शर्त क्या रखी थी। उन्होंने शर्त ये लिखी थी कि अपनी ओबिचुरी लिख के दो। ओबिचुरी समझते हैं ना, कि आप अगर मर जाए तो उसके बाद जो लोग आपके बारे में लिखते हैं वो कहते हैं वो लिख के मुझे भेजो, फिर मैं फैसला करूंगा तुम मेरे कोर्स में आ सकते हो या नहीं। वो क्यों लिखवा रहे? वो ये जानना चाहते थे कि मैं कैसे जाना जाऊंगा, मेरा क्या ख्याल है कि लोग मेरे बारे में क्या कहेंगे जब मैं यहां नहीं होऊंगा। वो बड़ा इंपॉर्टेंट, दैट्स व्हाट यू वांट, यू लिव इन द वर्ल्ड। आपने कोई महल बनाया, कोई और चीज की, व्हाट यू लीव इज दैट मेमोरी इन पीपल। हाँ, अच्छा आदमी था, हाँ उसने ये किया, हाँ बहुत बड़े दिल वाला था, लोगों की मदद करता था, लोगों के साथ चलता था। यही चीजें रह जाएंगी ना, और यही चीजें रह जाती हैं, यही याद आएंगी। किसी ने महल बना दिया तो उसका क्या फायदा हुआ? वो तो महल ही है, उससे ज्यादा कुछ नहीं। सो इट्स, आई मीन, आई एम नॉट सेइंग कि मनी इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट, योर करियर आर इम्पोर्टेंट, हैं, सबके होते हैं, लेकिन मनी, करियर वगैरह, वो रिमेम्बर, वो उसमें वो क्या होता है, जेन में एक बड़ी फेमस कॉन्सेप्ट है ना कि अगर आपने टारगेट को हिट करना है तो डोंट फोकस टू मच ऑन द टारगेट, गेट योर सेल्फ एंड योर माइंड प्रिपेयर्ड एंड यू विल हिट द टारगेट. इफ यू फोकस टू मच ऑन द टारगेट यू विल मिस इट, राइट, बिकॉज यू बिकम टू ब्लिंकर्ड. So that's the idea of preparing yourself to be all that you want to be and all that you can be. Aur wahan koi limit nahi hai. Limit lagayenge to aap apne aap pe khud lagayenge. Aakhri cheez main kehta hu, ek baat ka hamesha khayal rakhiye. Main hamesha apne student se kehta hu ke the right to make mistakes is your first right as a human. ह्यूमन राइट्स में सबसे पहला राइट क्या है? गलती करना. गलती नहीं करेंगे सीखेंगे नहीं. मैंने जितने आज तक इम्तिहान दिए, क्लासें दी, अभी तक मुझे याद है वो ओ लेवल्स में वो सवाल जो मैंने गलत किया था, मुझे वो सारे सवाल याद नहीं है जो मैंने ठीक किए थे, और वो काफी थे, लेकिन वो सवाल याद है मुझे जो मैंने गलत किया था. गलती करना आपका हक भी है और सीखने के लिए वो जरूरी चीज भी है. सो गलतियां कीजिए पर उनसे सीखिए जरूर. सीखने का अमल गलती से बहुत इंटेग्रली जुड़ा होना चाहिए. इफ यू आर एबल टू डू दैट तो फिर वो अलामा साहब ही कह गए थे ना, देन दैट कंडीशन विल बी. वो एक एनेक्डोट भी है ना अलामा साहब के बारे में कि वो जब बहुत बीमार थे जिंदगी के आखिरी अयाम में तो बिस्तर पे लेटे हुए थे, दरवाजा खुला, उनके साहबजादे जावेद इकबाल साहब अंदर तशरीफ लाए. अलामा साहब की हेयरिंग और उस वक्त तक नजर बहुत कमजोर हो गई थी तो उन्हें नजर नहीं आया कि कौन अंदर आया. तो उन्होंने ऊंची आवाज में पूछा, कौन? तो बेटे ने कहा, जावेद. उन्होंने कहा, अच्छा बन के दिखाओ. जावेद का मतलब जावेद. उन्होंने कहा, बन के दिखाओ. ठीक है. सो वो चीज आपको मैं कहता हूं और उनके उन्हीं के एक शेर पे ये खत्म करता हूं बात. ये मंजिल है जो आपकी है. खिरद को गुलामी से आजाद कर. आगे क्या है? खिरद को गुलामी से आजाद कर, जवानों को पीरों का उस्ताद कर. आज की दुनिया और कल की दुनिया आप सब की है. ये अब आप पे है कि आप उसको पकड़ते हैं, उसको उस फॉर्म में लेके जाते हैं जिसमें आप ले जाना चाहते हैं, या सिर्फ वो करते हैं जो किसी और शायर ने कहा था, क्या कहें अहबाब क्या कारे नुमाया कर गए, बीए किया नौकर हुए पेंशन मिली मर गए. ये चॉइस आपकी है. एंड सो इन द एंड wish you the very best of luck. If our paths ever cross each other, it would be an honor and privilege to be of any assistance that I can be, or I look forward to being led by some wonderful, wonderful next generation leaders. Thank you very much for being here.
थैंक यू सो मच. ये सिर्फ और सिर्फ एक झलक थी. आप ये सोचें कि मैंने बारी साहब से कोई तीन कोर्सेज लिए हैं और तीन डिफरेंट सेमेस्टर्स में मैंने इनसे वो कोर्सेज लिए हैं, तो ये इतनी कहानियाँ, एनेक्डोट्स, शेरो शायरी, उनकी एक्सप्लेनेशन, आई हैव बीन थ्रू ऑल दैट एंड आई रियली लव द वे सर इलेबोरेट्स ऑन डिफरेंट कंसेप्ट्स. खुद ही जाते जाते इन्होंने खुद ही को भी टच कर दिया, राइट, कि आप लोगों की जो खुदी है, सेल्फ रिफ्लेक्शन है. इफ यू आर राइटिंग योर ऑबिचरी इट मींस यू नो योर सेल्फ, राइट. अगर आपको अपना पता नहीं है देन यू कांट गो एंड से कि मैंने दुनिया को तब्दील करना है. पहले अपने आप को तब्दील तो कर लेना. द चेंज स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम विद इन, और विद इन से चेंज कैसे आएगी, कैसे तब्दील होगी, कैसे शुरू होगी, और वो तब से शुरू होगी इफ यू नो आवर सेल्फ बेटर. खुदी, सेल्फ रिफ्लेक्शन, इसी वजह से अमल का जो है प्रिंसिपल ऑफ प्रोग्रेस है, राइट. So with that, I will hand over to Hazra.
I feel absolutely privileged to thank our chief guest as well as our supporters from PepsiCo Pakistan who have taken out time from their busy schedules
to celebrate with us the success of our fellows. Can we please give them a big round of applause for making this moment, for making this ceremony so special? Here comes the last and the most awaited moment of the evening, for which I would like to call upon stage fellows who have shown matchless commitment and excellence throughout their fellowship journeys. Yes, I am talking about fellows who have secured the highest cumulative score in their respective batches. Yes, I am talking about the gold medalists. A big round of applause. All gold medalists are requested to please proceed towards the stage in an organized manner for a lovely group photograph. Managing team members are requested to please align our alumni for a photograph in Lahore, Karachi, as well as Peshawar. Thank you very much.
बैच 163 आपको अपने गोल्ड मेडलिस्ट पे नाज नहीं है? आर यू नॉट प्राउड ऑफ देम? बैच 164 ऑल राइट सो फ्रॉम कराची द गोल्ड मेडलिस्ट इज आयशा इस्माइल फ्रॉम बैच 175 Hamza Munawar from batch 176, Maliha Athar from batch 183, Fariza Fayaz from batch 187, Nabil Mustafa from batch 189, Bisma Salim from batch 194, Anika Kasim from batch 195. From Peshawar, from batch 169, we have Manahil Hafiz. From batch 190, we have Muhammad Waleed Bhatt. From batch 207, we have Abdul Muiz. From batch 209, we have Muhammad Ubaid.
Our gold medalists in Lahore include Abiha Saleem from batch 163, Muhammad Rahim Usman from 164, Fatma Tariq from batch 165, Irsa Rafiq from batch 167, Saad Ali from batch 171, Arij from batch 172, Komal Aziz from batch 173, Amna Jameel from batch 174, Sheikh Yasir Gibran from batch 178, Sijil Kokup from batch 179, Amber Amin from batch 180, Zainab Zafar from batch 181, Faizan Ahmed from batch 182, Mehroz Nasir from batch 185, Rabia Jameel from batch 192, Kashif Siddiqui from batch 197, Akifa Abbas from batch 198. Rida Tanveer from batch 199. Asad Ali from batch 200. Amber Saeed from batch 201. Zarish Kareem from batch 202. Arfa Maryam from batch 203. Zunaira Ijaz from batch 204, Rida Asif from batch 205, Muhammad Usman from batch 206, Raja Muzammil Hussain from batch 208, Rabia Mehreen from batch 210. A big round of applause for our gold medalists in Karachi, Peshawar and Lahore.
If we are done with the photograph, we can just take our places. Congratulations once again to our graduates and special awardees. The day is all about you and what you have achieved through Amal, Khudi, Kaam Kaam Kaam, aur ek gyara.
Not just our gold medalists, but every single fellow who is now an alumni, may you all look back to this stage in your life with fondness and pride. We will always look forward to hearing about your personal and professional achievements as you build onto the foundation provided by the Amal Career Prep Fellowship Program. We thank you once again for making this day so memorable. Wishing you all greater heights.
Now, once again, I would call Mr. Ali Siddiq to please come on stage and award souvenirs to our guests who joined us today despite their busy schedule and added color to this beautiful ceremony. So, first of all, I would like to call Anam Pasha on stage so that Mr. Ali Siddiq can present the souvenir. So as our chief guests are receiving their souvenirs, I will request all of you to please show some energy, right? Clapping to banti hai na? Haath thak gaye hain, bas thodi si der aur. Mr. Hatim Khan, again, and you are clapping. That's not the way.
Next, could we please have Mr. Mohammed Khosa with a big round of applause?
And at the last, I request Dr. Faisal Bari to please receive his souvenir. Dr. Faisal Bari.
Now, I would like our respected guests to please proceed towards the refreshments area. We would also like to thank our management team who spent long hours planning this amazing event, and not to forget our ushers and volunteers for providing constant support to our team in the execution of plans for this event. Audience, abhi event hamara khatam nahi hua. Aap sab please baithe rahiye. Aap sab ko bhi refreshments ka chance diya jayega. However, you are requested to remain seated because we are restarting the performances. And we will be cycling batch-wise outside for lovely batch photographs. Karachi and Peshawar, our audience, who are miles away, will be continuing their ceremony remotely. So we thank our audience who have joined us in Karachi, who have joined us in Peshawar, and not to forget our audience who joined us live on Facebook. Thank you so much for your patience.
और हमारे अजीज मोहतरम अमेजिंग ब्यूटीफुल एंड एनर्जेटिक फेलोज आई कैन सी द एनर्जी नाउ